Video Kiosk has lots of playback options. Of course, you know that it's easy to have your video kiosk running all the time, or that you could schedule playback for certain times of the day. But what if, instead, you could have your kiosk start displaying your content whenever someone walks up to it? In this video, I'm going to show you how easy it would be to use motion detection playback. Let's get started. Motion detection playback is a great option if people walk up to your kiosk, like in a retail display or a museum. Video Kiosk uses a camera on the Android device to detect motion and then starts playing. To use this feature, your Android device must have a front-facing camera. Most phones and tablets come with a camera installed. Most Android TVs do not. But you can buy a third-party USB camera to use with your Android TV. To use motion detection playback, follow these steps. Step 1. Enable video kiosk motion detection. Step 2. Optionally, configure the timeout when no motion is detected. Step 3. Launch video kiosk. Here's each step in detail. Step 1. Enable motion detection. Go to the video kiosk settings, schedule, detect motion, and enable use the camera to detect motion. Step 2. Optionally, you can configure the timeout when no motion is detected. The timeout controls how long video kiosk will continue to play when no motion is detected. The default is 5 minutes. We suggest you test run your video kiosk with that timeout and then adjust if necessary. Step 3. Launch video kiosk. Here's an example of how to use motion detection. Ronnie works at a museum and is installing a microcomputer exhibit. This is how he does it. For each microcomputer, they've created a video which displays a narrative text and speaks it as well. He creates a playlist for each microcomputer in the exhibit. He sets up a microcomputer and an Android tablet at each station. He moves all the video files and all the playlists to all the tablets using Video Kiosk's cloud update feature. Next, he edits the settings for each tablet. On each tablet, he changes the schedule settings to use motion detection playback, and then he changes the file and folder settings to use the playlist for that particular microcomputer. Now, he's ready to test the exhibit and make any adjustments to make the exhibit even better.
This is an original clamshell design Apple iBook from 1999. It featured a PowerPC G3 CPU and came with USB, Ethernet and modem ports, as well as an optical.
If he finds the narrative video for any of the exhibits is too long or too short, he can create a new narrative and update Video Kiosk with the new material. The new narrative will start playing automatically the next time playback is triggered.
This is a Sinclair ZX80 from 1980. The ZX80 came with 1 KB of static RAM and 4 KB of ROM. It had no sounds output. Offline storage was possible using a cassette tape recorder.
And because he's uploaded all the content to all the Android tablets, Ronnie has the flexibility to easily reconfigure the exhibit. If he wants to switch the places of some of the microcomputers, he just has to move the microcomputer to a new station and update the tablet at the new station to use the correct playlist.
This is an Apple PowerBook 170 from 1991. It was the high end of the original PowerBook series and a real workhorse.
He's thrilled that there's been so much interest in the exhibit, especially in the Ohio Scientific. The museum visitors just can't seem to get enough of a computer with a case made of wood.
This is an Ohio Scientific Challenger from 1978. It's a C2-8P system, which came with 4K of static RAM.
For step-by-step instructions on how to use each scheduling option, check out the other tutorials in this series. And for printed step-by-step instructions on how to use all of Video Kiosk's features, download the Video Kiosk User's Manual. You'll find the link below.
If you found this video helpful, please leave us a comment.